The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Let your loins be girded and your lamps burning, and be like men who are waiting for their master to come home from the marriage feast, so that they may open to him at once when he comes and knocks. Blessed are those servants whom the master finds awake when he comes. Truly I say to you, he will gird himself and have them sit at table, and he will come and serve them. If he comes in the second watch or in the third and finds them so, blessed are those servants." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to God, Jesus Christ.
My dear sisters, in today's first letter, St. Paul says that we are all children of Adam. Because of our first father Adam, sin and death came into the world. But there is no need of being hopeless. The new Adam brought grace and life for us. We are in the midst of the world. Whom do we represent or radiate more? Is it the sin of Adam or the grace of Jesus Christ? We are weak, frail, all right. The Lord understands us. The Lord wants us at the same time to be transformed by the special calling we have received from Jesus Christ the Lord and radiate him every day. In fact, today's responsorial psalm says, "Here am I, Lord, that I may do your will." We are all called to do the will of God and then bring glory to God. St. Irenaeus said, "The glory of man, the glory of woman is a man fully alive and active." Some of the sisters tend to think when they are 50, 60, 65, they are old. Not at all. You become old when you stop learning. When you stop doing good, then only you become old. Till the end of your life, you can contribute to the joy in the human family. If your hands and legs become inactive, you are not able to do much work, doesn't matter. As long as you can encourage people by your words, by your loving presence, by your encouragement, surely you are contributing. The glory of God is religious sisters, especially sisters of SAB, being active, energetic, smiling, cheerful, compassionate. We need to understand this aspect of our life. Let us not all the time reflect this sinful Adam, but Jesus Christ, full of grace and righteousness. Today we have a short passage for our gospel reading from the Gospel of St. Luke, 12th chapter, 35 to 38. You know, some of the early Christians were waiting for the second coming of Christ. Some of them became very tired. When at all the Lord will come? When will he give us eternal reward? Like that, as they were waiting, they became very tired and irritated. And this passage was an encouragement. We do not know when the Lord is going to come. What is your duty? Let your loins be girded and your lamps burning. So you know, people who want to work, sisters have some house coat and all, some men tie their towel on the waist and so on. Be ready to work, that's the meaning. Be ready to depart to the promised land. We recall Exodus, let your loins be girded, be ready. If so too long a cloth is hanging all round over, you can't do your work properly. You say, the Lord says, be ready all the time. Be ready all the time. Ready to serve. Ready to serve. And then he says, let your lamps be burning. Like the five wise virgins, not the stupid virgins. Not the stupid virgins. Be ready all the time. That should be our attitude, to meet the Lord. To open the door. To open the door of our heart. To open the door of our time. To open the door of our resources. Be ready all the time. Suppose I come there waiting and then going on ringing the bell, no electricity or nobody hears properly, I will be really irritated. All the time Sister Dominic, like the guardian angel, always waits for me to receive me for the Mass. Be ready. That is the thing. Be ready. The Lord is inviting you. Are you ready to work? Are you ready to welcome the Lord? Today the Lord doesn't come as if with all majesty and glory when during our everyday life. The Lord comes through individuals, through the human beings, through the children in the school, through the teachers in the school. Are you ready to welcome Him with a smile? All the time, your answer may not please them. Doesn't matter. You can be compassionate, kind, gentle, no? I was telling our seminarians also repeatedly, my dear brothers, people may find fault with you because you are not able to sing, you are not able to play any musical instrument, you are not studying well, you are not full of initiative, so many things. But one thing all can tell about you, they can call you a gentle seminarian, no? A gentle brother, no? A kind brother, no? This we can do the rest of your life, my dear sisters who are gathered here. You can be known as a gentle sister, not murmuring, grumbling, or doing anything else. No. A good Sabi sister, she is so gentle to us. That's enough. That we can do. Gently opening the door of your heart and doing something for the sake of the people. And then the Lord says, the master is coming after the marriage feast. If they open to him at once when he comes and knocks, blessed are those servants. Recently I was preaching in Madurai. I was saying, commenting on the expression where all it is said blessed, but I forgot this particular passage also. Elizabeth said, blessed are you who believed. Blessed are you among women, we say in the Hail Mary prayer. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. You are blessed among women because you believed. And Jesus, when later on hearing the praise of a woman for Mary, says, not only she believed, she listened to the word of God and did it. That's why she is more blessed, Jesus says. In his Sermon on the Mount, Jesus says, blessed are the poor in spirit, and according to Luke, blessed are the poor, the meek, the peacemakers. So all those things, the beatitudes are there. Blessed are those people. And to Peter, Jesus was saying, blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, the Lord revealed to you. And then during the Last Supper, Jesus says, after washing the feet, the servant is not greater than the master. If you know this, you are blessed. Mary also knew her role as servant. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, let it be done to me according to your word. She knew her role as servant. You are blessed, the Lord says. Here it is said, blessed are you if you are all the time ready to serve. That's it. Ready to open the door. Sometimes we go to a restaurant, we order a cup of coffee. Sometimes we used to think whether they have gone to bring the cow only to get some milk. So late, and then some of us get irritated and come away also by the time they bring coffee. Blessed are you when you are ready to open the door. Open the door for Jesus. Open the door for our brothers and sisters in need. Open the door of your time, energy, vitality, resources. You are blessed. And here he says, that servant is blessed who is ready to open when the master comes and knocks. The master finds you ready. We don't know when we will die. So many people, young and old, die of heart attack. Suddenly develop a particular sickness. Blessed are you till you die. Go on opening the door of your heart. The Lord will bless you abundantly. It is a rather strange scene. The master comes very late because the servant opens. Here it is said, the master is becoming the servant and serving the servant. The master becomes the servant. Just listen to this short verse. He will gird himself and have them sit at table, and he will come and serve them. The master is serving. What is contrast? Jesus is going to serve you. Jesus will not leave you unrewarded. Don't worry. Nobody appreciates me. The general team doesn't appreciate, or the provincials do not appreciate. The local superior is grumbling. I am slogging for the congregation. Don't worry. You are going to be served by Jesus. He is going to fill you with joy. He is going to fill you with joy. That is the message, loving message that Jesus is telling us. I am going to be your servant. My dear sister, I am going to be your servant. Because all along you have been ready and opening the door of your heart. And then the gospel passage, short passage, ends like this. If he comes in the second watch or in the third and finds them so, blessed are those servants. That blessed are you among women. Blessed are you who believed. Blessed are those who hear the word of God and do it. Blessed are those who recognize that they are only servants. Blessed are those who acknowledge that Jesus is the Messiah. One more blessed is mentioned in today's gospel. That blessed are those who are ready to open their hearts to Jesus. Blessed are those who constantly serve the Lord. This Eucharistic celebration we are participating, my dear sisters, is nothing but that. Jesus serving us with his body and blood. Nothing more to give. Life, his life, broken for us. His life shared with us. Take and eat. Take and drink. A servant, a true servant, doing the will of the Father and giving his people. May we be transformed by this great example of Jesus and listen to the invitation of Jesus to be good and faithful servants. Amen.